Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I want to set up some word problems for you. I'll give you the answers at the end, but I would like you to try to work these out on your own for the practice with multiplying and dividing. So, just hiked 1/9 of the Appalachian Trail, which is 2,151 miles. How many miles has she hiked? Well, when you want to know 1/9 of something or 1/5 of something, whatever that is, but the of is asking us to multiply. So we're going to take 2,151 and we're going to multiply by 1/9. And we can put a 1 under that to set that up correctly. Now, if it was me, I would probably check on a calculator to see if 9 goes into 2,151 or you could look at it this way. If you add up the digits 2, 3, 8, 9 all together, that is a multiple of 9, so that we know 9 is going to go into that number evenly. All right, try that problem. Pause the video, try the problem, and then come back and look at the second problem. At the end, I'll show you the answer to that one. Find the radius of a circle if the diameter is 1 3/5 inches. So remember, a diameter is something that goes all the way across a circle. So that's 1 3/5. And we want to find the radius, which is half of that. Again, we want to find half of something. So I want to take 1 3/5 and multiply it by 1/2. In order to do this problem, you need to change this into an improper fraction and then multiply. Try that and check your answer at the end of the video. All right, 6 girls want to share 4.5 pounds of candy evenly. How much will each of them get? Well, here's where things get a little tricky. Which number goes first? It doesn't really matter in a multiplication problem because of the commutative property says we can change the order without changing the answer. But it does matter if we want to divide. How do I know dividing? Because we're sharing things evenly. In other words, we're splitting things up or dividing it up. So if they want to share it evenly, what's being shared here, the candy or the girls? That's important because whatever is actually being shared has to go first. So we're sharing the candy amongst the 6 girls. So it's 4.5 pounds of candy that's being divided up between the 6 girls. In order to do this problem, you're going to need to change this into an improper fraction, put the 6 over 1, then find the reciprocal of that, and multiply after that. Okay. Again, that's a process on the last video. I want you to practice that by trying these problems. Find the average amount of rainfall per day if it rained 10 1/3 inches in 6 days. Well, you remember how we found the average before? We added everything up and then we divided by the number of things that we added. This has just been added up for us. So whenever you see find the average, you're going to have to divide in that problem. What is it we're dividing up? We're dividing the rain up into the number of days because we're actually asking how many inches per day. And so that shows you that the inches are on top in the division problem. So we're talking about 10 1/3 divided by 6. And then the same thing as the last problem, you're going to have to change this to an improper. Put the 6 over 1 and then find the reciprocal of 6 and multiply. Okay, in general, a person's wrist size is 1/4 of a person's waist size. What would be the wrist size of someone with a 35-inch waist? That was hard to read for some reason. So I'm asking here, what is 1/4 of that? That's a multiplication. So I'm back to multiplication. I'm going to say I have a 35-inch waist, and I want to multiply that by 1/4. I'm going to put that 35 over 1, and I'm ready to multiply. Notice that there's nothing to cancel there. So that shouldn't be too hard of a problem to get through. Okay, and the last one. The area of a rectangle is 10 1/2 inches squared. Find the length of the rectangle if the width is 2 1/2 inches. Well, first of all, we have to know that area equals length times width. So that if we know the area, we should be able to reverse that formula by dividing the area by one of these and we should get the other one. So it's actually a division problem. We're going to take 10.5 inches squared and divide by 2.5 inches. And when we do that division, we're going to get the length. Okay, let's just look at this one. Change it into an improper fraction. 10 times 2 is 20 plus 1 is 21. Change the division to multiplication. 2 times 2 is 4 plus 1 is 5 over 2. Whoops, we're still dividing here. I haven't flipped anything yet. That's just the rewriting that as an improper. Now I'm going to keep that dividend the same, and I'm going to flip the divisor or find the reciprocal of that, and that's going to become 2 over 5. Now I'm ready to multiply, and I can see that if I cancel those out, I get 1 on top and bottom for that. So I get 21 over 5, and if I want to change that to a mixed number, then that would be 4 and 1/5, because 5 goes into 21 4 times with 1 left over, and that would be inches. Okay, let's see how you did on the other ones that you did on your own. You should have gotten 239 miles for the first one, 4/5 of an inch for the radius of number 2. For number 3, each girl is going to get 3/4 of a pound, or 0.75 if you're thinking about it in decimals. For number 4, it rained about 1 13/18 of an inch, or if you left it as improper fraction, 31/18. For number 5, a person's wrist size is going to be about 8 3/4 inches. If you're taking 35 times 1/4, you get 35/4, which is about 8 3/4. Okay, go back and watch the other video if you had trouble completing these problems, the actual procedures. Hopefully I helped with setting them up, though. Have a fantastic day.